home to all known living things and people. Sometimes it seems that this is all we have, but all we have to do is look up to discover the cosmos.
Stars, windows to the past. The light you see when you look up at the night sky started its journey thousands, sometimes millions of years ago, infinite miles away.
It takes light, traveling at 186,000 miles per second, 8 minutes to get here. That means that the light you see right now started its journey from the sun about 8 minutes ago.
The light from Proxima Centauri, the closest star to our Earth, takes about 4.2 years to get here. While some of the other stars you see in the night sky aren't even there anymore, but they're so far away that their light is still traveling.
We connected the stars, made them in the shape of our constellation. The most well-known constellation is the Big Dipper.
The Big Dipper is really easy to spot in the night sky, and it is used to find Polaris, the North Star. Do you see the two stars at the end of the ladle? These are called Dubhe and Merak, and if you draw a line straight through them, they'll lead you to Polaris.
Ever since humans began looking up at the stars, we've been wondering who they are and where they came from. However, our astronomy wasn't born until a man named Galileo pointed his telescope at the heavens.
In this day and age, we all know that the Earth is round, and most of us know its circumference is 40,000 kilometers or 25,000 miles. But did you know who first accurately mathematically measured the Earth's circumference? The man who did this was named Eratosthenes. He had a colleague that said, once a year, you could see straight down a well, and the statues in the cities didn't have any shadows. Eratosthenes decided to investigate, and on that day, he measured the shadow of a statue in Alexandria, while his friend Syene looked down the well. Syene is about 500 miles away, and the shadow cast in Egypt was 7 degrees. With this, he was able to determine that 500 miles was 7 degrees of the Earth's circumference.
Nicholas Copernicus was born in 1473. He died in 1543, and he was the man who reintroduced the heliocentric system back into the world. Tycho Brahe was born in 1546 and lived to 1601. He was a Danish astronomer, and he was commissioned by the Danish king to study the stars. Now, he was known for his unbelievable accuracy when looking at the stars, using some of the biggest protractors the world has ever seen. Johannes Kepler was born in 1571 and lived to about 1630. Early on, he was recognized as a mathematical genius, so Brahe took him as an apprentice. Kepler had three very important laws on planetary motion. One!
Kepler said that planets orbit the sun in an oval-like shape called an ellipse, around two focal points. As the satellite moves closer to Earth, it gains speed, and as it moves away, it loses it. This is Kepler's law of equal areas.
3.
This shows the planet's distance from the sun versus how long it takes them to orbit.
Galileo Galilei was born in 1564 and died in 1642. He was perhaps the most well-known astronomer who ever lived. He was the one who pointed his telescope at the stars, revealing so much more than we could see with the naked eye.
Now, Aristotle
was a genius who lived from 384 BC to 322 BC. He imagined this universe where the Earth is at the center and the Sun revolves around it, as do all the other planets, in perfect circles and everything is perfect spheres. The Catholic Church, liking his idea of such divinity in the universe, adopted this idea and made it into holy law. Now, the four famous astronomers we just talked about each had their own idea about how the solar system worked that didn't exactly line up with Aristotle's, therefore going against the church. Nicholas Copernicus imagined a heliocentric system, whereas the sun is in the center and the earth actually goes around the sun. Now, that just seemed preposterous in the time, but it turns out he was right. Tycho Brahe imagines a system where the Earth is still at the center, going with Aristotle, but Mercury and Venus actually go around the Sun, which goes around the Earth. Now, this was an interesting idea, but he was completely wrong. Johannes Kepler was Tycho Brahe's assistant. Now, Tycho feared his genius and hid his observations from him. After he died, Kepler inherited all the observations Brahe had made so precisely. And with these observations, he was able to calculate that the sun is in the center while the earth goes around it, but they don't go in circles. They go in these oval-like shapes called ellipses. Galileo Galilei, perhaps the most well-known of all these astronomers, had the biggest advantage. He had a telescope. Now, with his telescopes, he observed the moons of Jupiter, he observed the moon, and even the sun. And with this information, he believed in the Copernican system.
Middle of the road!
God, I thought his shadow was a car. I'm like, he's gonna die.
Put your hands on the steering wheel. Even slow pace.
Keep going.